Hello, I'm Mr. R. Major, retired lecturer in hematology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm rendering exposition of Luke 6, 27 onward, which is also known Sermon on the Mount. And here I want to tell you that the things, why they are opposite. Now, we have, you know, here, the people, sons of man, tribal people who go to the synagogue to learn moral laws. They are natural men born of parents, you know. And then they are children, you know, 12 years, 16 years old, sent to the rabbi. And he teaches them the moral law of Moses. Moral law applied to our flesh, and they are there to build your extrinsic value. Extrinsic. That means if somebody hit you, you hit him back. Natural law. All these moral laws are based on natural laws. Tit-for-tat. It's only when you become spiritual, then you realize, you know, that in everyone is the light of our Father. Everyone is the son of our Father God. So when you realize that you are born, I was born in India, somebody in America, some in Africa, our soul was sent by our Father God into different countries. And so people of the different countries are one, of one world, because these boundaries doesn't exist in spiritual language. Boundaries are in Adam, not in God. God is universal. Adam, we have tribes, races, and other things. So we have, like, I'm living in this house, is Niger, my house. Same you have the country, you know, belonging to people of certain tribes. So they are divided, you know. So to upkeep their extrinsic values, they fight with each other and kill. But in spiritual one, you know, you when you realize that we are one family, you dare not hit the other person. Because when you hit him, you are hitting the one which is inside him. Our Father's light. So you present the other cheek. You hit at the conscience of the person. You want to awaken his conscience. People who have no conscience, they are sons of devil. They are evil-spirited people. Like the Jewish people, you know, Jesus, when he was sitting in the temple, after, you know, they have caught the woman in adultery, that would have produced a bastard, you know. But when you become a Jew outwardly, you say bye-bye to your tribal father, and you become a bastard worse than those born of the prostitutes. That is called super bastard fanatic devils. That is what's happening in the world now. You can see how they are killing and hating each other. So when you know that we are one Father, spiritual Father, this love is eros and that love is agape, agape. And when you become philosophical, then that love turns into filial love. And when you are one with God, that love is called storge love. Four types of loves. Four spiritual states and four types of love. Eros, agape, philia, storge, highest. So with this introduction, now you will understand why Jesus said, turn the other cheek. And material thing, you know, remember, when the first church of God was formed, people sold their property, all the material possession, to join the Church of God, communal life. where they were like communists, you know, they were everything sharing. That is real communism. But as the human nature is, soon after, you know, the time passed, some crook came into the church, Messianic Jews with Torah under their armpit, and they created greed again. Greed. There was no bank before, you know, there were any money over the, what was left over, it was sent to the needy people around the world. But when the Pope became Messianic Jew, they kept it. They built big, big churches and all that, you know, with that money. So to attract more Mammon, more people come. So these churches with the dog collar priest, from which our anointed elder brother Christ Jesus got rid of by giving his own sacrifice, they have come back in greater force, as mentioned in Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45. The arid spirited temple priest, you know, who was sacked, they are nothing else, they are not capable of doing anything else. They came into the church of God and made the situation worse than before. They created Pope equivalent to their temple high priest. And all these fathers, you know, they used to be called father to rabbis. Standing at the marketplace, people will call them father, father, father. So this is the Antichrist organization. In Jesus, you have to be royal priest. Royal priests are solitary, because they can find the narrow gate and enter into it. If you are two, you can't. So you need to be solitary, which we call virgin brides. In Punjabi, we call it Sohagan. Sohagan means unmarried woman. Same thing as virgin bride. So with this introduction, now you will understand why the things are opposite in narration to the natural laws. Because we are spiritual people, we don't hate, we love, and our Father is love and mercy, and we extend that one through these demonstrations. But I say to you who hear, love your enemies, do good to those who hate you. People hate you, you know, or steal your money, or hate you with hand. You hit him with your conscience. You hit at the conscience of the person, not at the body, conscience. Bless those who curse you, conscience again. Pray for those who abuse you. Now, normally, you know, we don't pray, you know, twice born people. But to once born people, they pray. So prayer is the language they understand. So you pray for them as angel Stephen pray when they were stoning him to death. So to one who strikes you on the cheek, offer the other also. And from one who takes away your cloak, do not withhold your tunic either. That means somebody's want to steal, give him what he want, because he need it, you know. And if he has a conscience, you know, he won't steal. But if he's a greedy person, he will. Greed only exists where there is disparity of rich and poor. Greed did not exist among the Samaritan people or among the communists. Remember when the ruble went down, you know, some years ago, a man broke into the flat of a poor man, and he found that he is poorer than himself. So instead of stealing, he left some money over there for the poor man. That is conscience, you know. Those people have conscience. Mammon, they will take away more than that, you know. Your cloak, do not withhold your tunic, give to everyone. who begs from you. Begging is the worst profession, you know. And that if you are fit, you know, you should work and earn your own living. They have no conscience, you know. So he is telling you, awaken his conscience, you know, by giving him whatever he wants. And from one who takes away your goods, do not demand them back. Thief, you know, don't ask them back, you know, let him keep it. And as you wish that others would do to you, do so to them. That is the conscience, you know, that hit them at their conscience by doing the same as you wish to be done. If you love those who love you, what benefit is that to you? That means you just reciprocate, you respond it, you know, love to love, you know. If somebody invited you to dinner, then you invite him next time and he will, to repay him, you know, you invite him back. So that is not philanthropy. Remember the Samaritan man who picked up the wounded person and he looked after and paid the inn man money to look after him. That is philanthropy. He did not ask or did not tell the wounded person who he is. If he tells him who he is, then he will try to find him and give him his money back. He did not. That is philanthropy. For even sinners love those who love them. That is what the arrows, you know, people, once born people. Sin is among the once born people, not among the twice born. Twice born people know the thing, know the moral law, they do it knowingly. When they do it knowingly, it becomes hypocrisy. So twice born people, they are hypocrite. Sinners are those who are ignorant of the law. And if you do good to those who do good to you, what benefit is that to you? If he does good, you do good, what benefit it is? So do good to them which they can't return back. That it become a philanthropy, act of philanthropy. For even sinners do the same. And if you lend to those from whom you expect to receive, what credit is that to you? Even sinners lend to sinners to get back the same amount. Sinner to sinner means the once born people. Because twice born people, they are not sinners, they are hypocrites. Like cheat, you know, cheating the simpleton people, they are hypocrites, you know. Like these dog collar people in the churches, they are working for mammon and not for God. They are cheating the congregation, they are hypocrites. So only the sensible people do not sin, but they are hypocrite. So these sensible dog collar people in the churches are politicians, you know. They are hypocrites. They tell lies and everything, you know. But love your enemies and do good. That is how you hit his conscience, you know. Not hit his body, hit his conscience. And lend expecting nothing in return. And your reward will be great. Great from the heart. He is paying you back. Not in this money, but he has given you his heart, which money can't buy. So it's much greater than paying him back. And you will be sons of the Most High, because High, he rests in our heart and not in mammon house, you know. This is built by nature, Yahweh. For he is kind to the ungrateful and the evil. As the rain falls on every place, you know, so his blessing of our Father on everyone is up to you to use it or to misuse it. That is what I mean, Holy Spirit is planted in your heart, and you know when you are cheating somebody, you are doing wrong, but you do it, you misuse it. If you do for the benefit of humanity, then it remains holy, otherwise it's evil. That is how the Gentiles behaved, but the Messianic Jews started to kill them for preaching gospel. Messianic Jews, they were greedy, you know. Gentiles were preaching gospel without taking any money. But they were having dog collars, money. Then they will come to the church people, they will ask them to give money. Like Pope, you know, collecting money from the poor farmers in Ireland. The priest will go around, give for the Pope. He will take it by force, you know. They wanted darkness worse than those, worse than before the arrival of Jesus, to fulfill Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45. That is why Hazrat Mohammed Sahib, you know, he came from the Gentile, from the Egyptian side. Remember the Jesus, when he was a baby, he was sent to Gentile because they were faithful to Abraham and had the qualities of Abraham. So Hazrat Mohammed Sahib and his people, they had the qualities of Abraham. So he took to sword power to sort them, sort these greedy people up. And that Islam, when went to India, that Islam of force, sword is not real Islam. Real Islam is submission to the will of Allah, not to submission to the will of a man. But the man start imposing his views. So this Islam is of Insh Mullah, not of Insh Allah. So when Insh Mullah Islam went to India, over there, you know, it was misused. Still, some of those mullahs, they withheld the moral laws which were in the Quran. And they won't kill an innocent person under 16 years old, you know, or something which is a child. So the last royal king, you know, last prophet on earth, Gobind Rai, who became Gobind Singh, he was the last prophet on earth. Two came in Middle East, two in India, Nanak and Gobind Singh. There are two in India. So two of his sons, you know, he had four sons, two were underage children, and these Mohammedan, they got hold of them, and they wanted to kill them, you know. So they want the permission of the mullah. So he invited mullah to give a final verdict. They said they should die. Mullah said no, they can't die, because they are underage. They don't know. You can't spill the blood of a child. Then one of the Khatri in that town, Sarhand, he said, why to kill them? Put them in wall. Break them in the wall alive. When you break them in the wall alive, you haven't killed them. They die of suffocation of themselves. So you know blood has been spilled. What a clever idea of a Khatri. And that is what they did, you know. So there was people who were with upholding the law in Mullah, you know, they were good. But when they became forced, you know, forcing people to turn into Islam by circumcision, you know, the circumcision is the covenant of Abraham to Isaac, is a tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac, not to Gentiles. Only the sons born of the seed of Isaac, only they could be circumcised, nobody else. But these, when Jesus came, these temple priests, they were going long distance to circumcise somebody who is not a Jew, or who is not in line of Abraham, they will circumcise him and make him a Jew, and then they say, no, you are son of Abraham. How could he be son of Abraham? Like in India, people are going have a circumcision, Mohammedan. Now they are Mohammedan. Now what Indian have to do with Semitic race? We are Aryan race, they are Semitic. So their circumcision doesn't make you son of Abraham. So this is the darkness they have, you know. That's what, when Stephen was telling them that our forefather Abraham was a noble man and uphold his seed, uphold his honor. Don't make people sons of Abraham through circumcision. Don't catch Gentile and make them like that. You are dishonoring our father. And then they were grinding their teeth that this man is stifling our business. He is stopping us. We were making money out of this one. He's come here to stop it. That's why they were grinding teeth and trying to kill him. And that's why they stoned him to death. He wanted to make them sons of Abraham, not those by circumcision, but through the seed of Isaac, which is covenant is circumcision, of course, but not everybody can take it, have it. I note that some people in Africa, they are quite, circumcision is quite common, you know, and you can see how stupid people are, you know, how religion has gone mad. That's why Christ Thomas said, first know what you see with your two naked eye. Then what is not seen of the invisible God would be known to you. That is through revelations. That led to the appearance of the second anointed Christ in the name of Satguru Nanak Dev Ji. Be merciful even as your father is merciful. So the second coming of Jesus had taken place. Now the end of the world is approaching. And that's why the tares are bundled up in Israel for final burning. Matthew 13 verse 24 to 30 is getting fulfilled in the establishment of Israel and bundling up the tares. That's why people in Europe, they have started to kill them, as they did when they killed Stephen and St. James the Just. The people in the villages, they start to kill Jewish people. And when they start killing them, they ran to Jerusalem for protection. In 66 AD, then the Roman invaded and put a wall around it, besieged them, great siege. For 4 years, they suffered at the hands of the robber, which they exchanged for Jesus. Our Father God blesses you.